using satellite observations to support aviation, in particular aviation hazards. And as planes, you know, flights go back and forth across the oceans, there's no measurements to determine where hazards exist. And the way we find about them now is planes fly into them. And one thing satellites can do is identify in that imagery, in the analysis, in those sequences of imagery from geostationary satellites in particular, where threats, where hazards are. And applying the research that we're doing, working with NOAA to develop operational algorithms that can warn pilots that this is potentially a hazardous area, maybe you should fly around it. As we move into next generation satellites, we have more capability in terms of the temporal sequences, in terms of the spatial resolution, in terms of the spectral resolution. And whenever you want to improve forecasting with satellites, those are the three things that you want. You want better temporal resolution, better spatial resolution, better spectral resolution. And that's what the next generation weather satellites are bringing us. So when I talk about spectral resolution, I mean about wavelengths. So our eyes are sensitive to certain wavelengths, but there are other wavelengths that allow us to peer into the atmosphere where our normal visual can't see. And what that enables us to do is to look at patterns of circulation in the atmosphere, particularly up and down patterns, which generates turbulence. But also certain wavelengths allow us to distinguish between ice in a cloud and liquid water in a cloud. That associated with the temperature of the cloud allows us to identify where icing conditions may occur. And that's certainly areas where aviation doesn't want to be flying into. This is again another advantage where the university step in to help NOAA, because we conduct a lot of research, not just with NOAA, but with NSF, with NASA, with DOD. And so one of the things we've developed over the past couple of years through these other collaborations is, how do you detect supercooled water? And in doing that, we use research satellites. Now that we've developed techniques, we can now transfer those research science into operational sciences through collaborations with NOAA through the Cooperative Institute. So we can take the things we developed in research and work with NOAA to get them into NOAA operations. Then it's going into the forecasters and hopefully someday right into the cockpit. I think it's a really exciting time. I mean, if you look at the geostationary satellites that we have up there right now, they're really based on designs that were done in the 1980s. And we're still doing really useful and good things with them. But with this next launch of the GOES-R series, you know, we're taking another step in the amount of information and the amount of science and the amount of weather forecasting we're going to be able to do with these new series. And we're really looking forward to that.